Mga Kanation, what comes to mind when you hear Mexican food? Maybe your favorite burrito spot or taco truck. Well, one restaurant in the heart of the Presidio National Park here in San Francisco is trying to teach us about the different tastes of Mexico that might not be so obvious to many. So here we have with us the general manager of Arguello restaurant in the Presidio, Kyle Kralowitz. Hi, Kyle. Hi. And welcome to Adobo Nation.
Thank you for joining us. Welcome, welcome.
Sounds great. You have prepared a nice little spread for us here. Some of the things I'm familiar with, some of the things not so much, but this is kind of what you guys are really trying to do here at Arguello is maybe introduce food cuisine from other states of Mexico.
Absolutely. Our chef de cuisine, Jose Alvarez, and I really are inspired by the traditional Mexican cuisine. Mm-hmm. We're trying to bring kind of parts of that to San Francisco mm-hmm. and kind of explore what that looks like mm-hmm. with some delicious flavors.
Well, this is perfect because as I mentioned just a little while ago, you guys are right here in the heart of the Presidio. And you know, the Presidio is a great place to learn so much about different cultures, about the history of San Francisco and different cultures as well. So we're learning more about different culinary tastes in Mexico. Let's start off with some of the things that you prepared that are probably more common and known.
Yeah, no, these are some of our favorites that you can always find on our lunch menu. You know, a big part of Mexican cuisine that doesn't get highlighted a lot, I think, is the seafood. You know, it's coastal, it's on the Gulf, it's on the Pacific. They have a lot of beautiful seafood dishes. So we do have a snapper ceviche featured up here with some plantain chips, kind of more of like the Yucatan, Gulf of Mexico kind of style.
That's right, because I always kind of think Peruvian food if I think ceviche, but Mexico also has a very rich seafood.
Beautiful access to tons of, you know, local fisheries and things like that. So seafood is definitely something you'll find at Arguello on almost all of our menus. Some of our favorite tacos at lunch, at least for me personally, are our seafood tacos.
Uh-huh.
The grilled shrimp, the Baja style kind of crispy fish taco. It's delicious. Mm-hmm. And yeah, we have crispy tacos, our Dorados featured mm-hmm. here, taquitos as well with shredded chicken. And then we also have a bunch of beautiful lighter fare, like our heirloom tomato salad for the summer with avocado mousse. This is actually probably one of our favorites in the park, whether you're an employee or coworker of ours or colleague. This is our head chef Jose Alvarez's mother-in-law's recipe from Michoacan. It's a traditional pozole, pozole verde. Pozole meaning hominy, the puffed corn grain that you'll find in the soup. It's delicious, and we can't get enough, and we're just trying to share it with everybody.
I know you're saying that this is a favorite from everybody kind of within the park, too.
Absolutely.
This is, it looks like it's homemade goodness.
It probably, I can't think of a better way to describe it than that. It's made with a lot of love, and I think you can taste that in a lot of Chef Jose's food.
Well, that's great, because then you also, you know, you mentioned that you guys are opening kind of the doors to different cuisines in Mexico, but you also have some of the staples, which is like the delicious, you know, guacamole that probably is kind of a staple, but you guys make it special in-house.
Every day. You know, I jokingly say that we have the best guacamole in San Francisco, but I'm kind of only slightly joking. it's super delicious, and yeah, we can't get enough of that either. Homemade tortilla chips as well. You know, paying attention to the staples and the basics, I think, is something that sets Arguello apart from a lot of other traditional Mexican restaurants you might find in the city.
Fantastic. Well, so you guys also offer some delicious drinks. I'm going to try some of the from this in-house guac here.
Please do.
Because it just looks delicious. I mean, you literally see like huge chunks of avocado in there.
Yeah.
Super fresh.
And again, it's simple. It's one of our favorite things about Mexican food, right? Mm-hmm. Like it's just avocados, some citrus juice, onions, you know, a little bit of serranos, but it's not too hot. But again, a couple basic ingredients that are allowed to shine, I think is the best way to enjoy Mexican food.
Oh my God, that is delicious. Right. And you were saying that's also kind of the philosophy with some of the drinks. Keep it simple.
Yeah.
That's for the house margarita. That's what you guys do as well.
I wouldn't be able to talk about Arguello if I didn't talk about our bar program here as well.
Mm-hmm.
We offer over 120 agave-based spirits. You know,
oh,
a lot of times we think about tequila, but that also encapsulates mezcal, Bacanoras, Sotols, Ricillas. There's a whole world of agave-based spirits that many people don't think about when they think about a tequila bar.
That's totally true. So it extends way further than just, you know, your more popular tequila.
Totally. Tequila, interesting enough, is kind of like champagne. There's a denomination of origin. So there are a lot of restrictions on what plants can be used to make it, what states it can be made in. But that doesn't mean that it's not made all throughout the country. So outside of that, you know, you can only call champagne what's made in Champagne. But outside of that, it's referred to as mezcal, and depending on the technique and manufacturing processes, has different names. And so we try to feature a lot of those as well.
Very cool. So with the in-house margarita, you obviously use tequila with this, right?
Yes, yes.
But you keep the ingredients simple. Tell us about that.
Yeah, very simple. Again, we like to taste our tequila. So we just use 100% Blue Weber Agave Blanco tequila, fresh squeezed lime juice, and a little bit of agave nectar to sweeten it up, but not much. And we find that's the best way to kind of balance out the tequila while still kind of tasting it. And yeah, we find that our house margarita is very, very popular. And yeah. Again, keep it simple.
I might have to just try the house margarita to see if you're lying to me, Kyle.
I would never ginger that.
Yeah, this new mom's gonna have some of the margarita. But you also have obviously non-alcoholic options. Before we do get there, I want to touch on this beautiful drink here.
Yeah, this is a really fun drink we made. It's called the Diego y Frida. You know, inspired by Diego Rivera, the famous muralist who has a bunch of artwork actually in San Francisco as well. The cocktail was inspired by the state of Guanajuato, which is where Diego Rivera was born, which is where it kind of gets its name. Obviously, there's some tequila in there. There's also a little bit of pineapple sour beer as well.
Wow.
So you're kind of playing with two different spirits, the Diego and the Frida. Frida's from Mexico City, which is right next to Guanajuato. So it's kind of our play with duality of spirits and location. But it's also been a really popular drink that we're featuring.
Fantastic.
As well.
Now for the non-alcoholic option, you've got a popular Agua Fresca.
Probably one of my favorite flavors, the watermelon Agua Fresca. Again, just like the guacamole, we're making fresh Agua Frescas every day, kind of based on what's in season and what we have fresh access to. But again, Agua Frescas, if you're not familiar, it's just kind of like a fruit drink. And yeah, it's really delicious. Today we're featuring watermelon, a nice summer fruit that makes a delicious Agua Fresca.
All right. Well, cheers to that, Kyle. It's been a pleasure learning more about the offerings here at Arguello. I have to work on my Spanish accent.
You know what?
I do.
Both pronunciations are okay. If you grew up in San Francisco, a lot of us are familiar with Arguello Boulevard. But being in the Presidio and the National Park, this was founded by the Spanish, and Arguello is a surname of the first commandant. So if we're referring to the surname, it's Arguello. If we're referring to the boulevard, it's Arguello, which we're right off of. So there's no wrong way to
either way.
It.
Well, yeah. I love it. Okay, I want to make sure that we go through the details for our viewers so they know just where to find you guys, because it's tucked away in a little corner here at the Presidio, which makes for a beautiful setting.
Yeah. Okay. The location, I think, is one of our favorite parts about this restaurant. You know, we have the patio, overlooks the Golden Gate Bridge and the bay. We're right up at the old officers club at the end of the parade field on the main kind of portion of the Presidio. And yeah, we're open for dinner Wednesday through Saturday, and we're open to the public Tuesday through Sunday.
Fantastic. All right. Good stuff, Kyle. And I can see you've got a lot of people. No worries. You've got a lot of people during lunch, happy hour, and going into dinner with that beautiful San Francisco view right behind you.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you so much. Again, cheers. Thanks, Kyle.
Of course. Thank you for coming up and joining us.